Hey everyone, today is Sunday and I bring you one of my special episodes which I make especially for you, my young people. Now, I'm going to share a couple of data with you which I'm sure that most of you know already, but I'll still share them with you. The Swachh Survekshan 2020 conducted by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has declared Jorhat as the cleanest city in the Northeast zone. That is fantastic news, Jorhat. Congratulations to all of you. And along with Jorhat, there are some other cities which have also been given this accolade and they have secured positions on the list of cleanest cities this year. The cities are Tejpur, Difu, Sibsagar and Karimganj. Congratulations to these four cities, you've done great. Now all of you Guwahatians must be wondering, some of you already know this terrible news, you must be wondering where Guwahati is right now. Well, last year we were in the 303rd position in 2019 and in 2020 we are in the 356th position. Why so, Guwahatians? Why are we in such a dismal position? We have come down, we have degraded ourselves in this cleanliness drive. But have you noticed that we have garbage all around? We have become a city of garbage. There are garbage dumps everywhere. There's absolutely no concern about disposing the garbage in the proper manner. I don't know where you people are, what you people are doing and how you are disposing your garbage. But I'm sure, I'm not talking about everyone, okay? The ones who are concerned are disposing their garbage properly. But then there are certain number of people who are absolutely rampantly dirtying the city. Recently, I tweeted about the GMCH hilltop. And I asked Sarbananda Sonwal, sir, our Honorable Chief Minister, please, sir, give us some more dustbins. We need dustbins. We need dustbins in dozens, in hundreds, all across the city. Because right up there in the GMCH hilltop, people are littering up with plastic, with their garbage, with cans, with used cans and chips packets and everything. Come on, people, you can't be making a dumping ground of the city everywhere you go. I'm telling you this, if you are going to listen to this video, I'm sure if some of your friends who visit that hilltop actually can pass on this video, then I think you should be ashamed of yourself if you are doing this. And if you're not doing anything, if the students who are there, it is said that this is just very near the GMCH campus on the hilltop, and if the students are not doing anything, then it's a shame on them as well. I think the onus lies on all of us. The onus does not simply lie on the government. It lies on all of us to keep the city clean. The government has given us dustbins. The government has given us a whole lot of waste disposal vans to pick the garbage from our homes. But what are we doing? I will tell you a little story which happened a couple of years back. I was returning from a meeting and I see this van in front of me, a school van in front of me, and there are some, I think there must have been some children inside. There were some children inside. I'll tell you how I know this. I followed this car because I could see chips packets being thrown out of both sides of the window. I followed this car right up to where they stopped, and then when they got down, I asked them, from which school do you belong to? And they told me about their school. And I said, is this what they teach you in your school? Is this how you dispose your garbage? You have thrown a lot of things back there and you have been dirtying the streets. Who are you expecting to clean up? Me? The person who comes to clean the garbage? Just because you have paid your taxes? Is this what you do to the city? I mean, shame on you. Why am I telling this? Because these are young students from a school and I'm sure their parents have not taught them anything. Since their parents have done it, that is why the children are doing it. If my mother had taught me as a young girl that I am not supposed to throw banana peels and orange peels out of that ASTC and MSTC buses that we used to travel to from Shillong to Guwahati and Guwahati to Shillong, she used to put them into a little doggy bag and then dispose it in the first dustbin that she sees, or she's to dispose it at home. Now, if she had taught me that when I was a little girl, since I was in class nursery and traveling to and fro from Guwahati, Shillong, then why aren't the other parents teaching this to their children? My dear parents, my dear elders, the ones who are very literate, very educated, let me explain to you that staying in a dirty city is absolutely rubbish. It is the most disgusting thing to happen. And when we come up with a data like this, we are in the 356th position in 2020 as the dirtiest city. What a shame on us. What a shame on us. Just yesterday, I think, or day before yesterday, Bhaskar Debokumar, a very renowned advocate of the Guwahati High Court, had put up a picture of Bir Lasit Borfukon's statue in the Brahmaputra, and he said, he wrote a whole piece out there, very beautiful piece. He said that, "I am ashamed to put up pictures of Lasit Ghat because it's so dirty. People have dirtied it so much that he's ashamed to put up pictures." He just put up the picture of Lasit Borfukon's statue. That's it. But he could not think of putting up any picture of that surrounding area because he's so embarrassed. Now, shouldn't all of you be feeling embarrassed about your city? Or are you already used to it? Are you already used to the fact that we live in a garbage city? Why aren't you demanding from your government that we need dustbins? I have been writing to the government every day on Twitter that we need dustbins, we need people to clean up the system, we need regular cleanliness drives. And it's the people again. Okay, government is going to do it. We will keep demanding, and the government is going to accept it. But what about us? The onus lies with us. We are the ones who actually go and throw our garbage into the bins, right? Why can't we put it in the right place? For your information, I'll tell you that we have 130 garbage disposal bins in the city. We have around 60 garbage collecting vehicles, and we have 90 NGOs selected for waste collection. So all these people are working, but we also have to work hard to keep our city clean. I think we should ask the government to fine anyone who is found littering, spitting, urinating in the open and dirtying the city. I think it's high time we did something, because without the proper rules in place, nobody's going to do anything about it. Because I can see that Guwahatians are absolutely not bothered. Till we are neck deep, we are covered in filth, in garbage, in dirt. And that is when all of you are going to say, okay, now we should call out. When you are stuffed with garbage, then is the time you'll call out. Then is the time you'll wake up. So why I'm doing this video is because I want the young people to take action. Please write about it. Write about it in your blog. When you're writing blogs about different subjects, write about this subject as well. Demand from your government what you want. If there are no dustbins in your area, demand for dustbins in your area. It is high time you did something for your city. You just can't be sitting there and doing nothing. Please, my young friends, wake up. Take a call. Make those demands. Speak up. Write up. You can do so much. And you call yourself influencers. If you can influence even an inch of the government, you will feel very good inside. If they can help you with this mammoth problem that we are having right now, we are facing right now, it'll be great. I'm telling you, I'll be the first person to thank all of you. And why do I keep appealing to the young people to take the onus to pick up the mantle? Because it's you who are the leaders. It's you who is going to be the future leaders. So start acting now. You'll be proud to say that at the age of 21, 22, 23 or 18, 19, I actually did this for my city. Wake up, my dear friends. Because on a daily basis, Guwahati has 500 tons of waste which is generated. That's on a daily basis which is generated, which is fine. I mean, in a city which is growing and in a city which is, you know, increasing, the population is increasing day by day, it is absolutely natural. But then we also have to think how we are going to do this. How are we going to tackle this garbage problem? And let us not throw even a single piece of paper out on the streets just like that. Can we find a dustbin and actually throw our garbage into that dustbin? Properly inside the dustbin and not outside? Can we do that, please? Yes, the government will keep doing. The government has to do it. I have been demanding and commanding and asking them for dustbins. Now it's your turn, young people. Write to them. Write to the government that we want dustbins in the proper places. We want more cleanliness drives. We want committees who are going to be there and looking after the cleanliness of the city. Because it's no pride being in the 356th position. And in a play, I mean, and especially in a year where we are talking about cleanliness when the virus is around. A few days ago, they were saying that no, there'll be no spitting around. There'll be 500 rupees fine if anybody's found spitting. But I find people rampantly spitting around everywhere. I speak to them and I say, you will be fined for 500 rupees if you spit like this in the open. But then there's absolutely no control over spitting. There's no control. I feel that the government should deploy more people. I mean, police-like people, if they are not, they should be in plain clothes, and catch hold of these people who actually litter the city in any form. Throwing garbage, spitting, urinating in the open, anything. I think the government should do that. This is my request to the government. This is my request to the public. Please start keeping your city clean, because very soon you're going to be filled with garbage, even inside your homes. Don't think just because you're keeping your homes clean, it's not going to come inside. The garbage out from outside is going to come inside in many different ways. Not literally, but through the virus, through bacteria, through all kinds of diseases. So wake up, Guwahatians, wake up. I am requesting you, please wake up. It's time now.